organic texture seating in for Flora. Number two, maker and model Suzanne Lemberg. Forest fish. Forest fish is a displaced specimen from the tropics that landed in the breathtaking canopy of the evergreens. Leather scales upcycled from a jacket and silk scarf shredded to wrap around a spandex-based set of leggings and a top that forms a shiny bodysuit. Equipped with skills for breathing in the forest mossy, humid air, forest fish thrives in the... Number three. And this is Glow-to-Web, or Flower Face. The model is Shannon O'Neill. This is our interpretation of Glow-to-Web, created from flowers to be a Welsh hero's wife. She fell in love with another man and was cursed to live as an owl. Here, the owl goddess returns to the forest to trade for mortal life, love, loss, womanhood, a predatory bird. A mythical tale of transformation from Flora to Fauna. Brought to life with a discarded wedding dress, yards of surplus fabric, and rolls of lacy tulle.
Glow-to-Web.
That's adorable.
Next we have number four. Maker and model, Kelly Lenoir. Frolicking in the spring with ferns, fawns, and berries.
Girls in the front row, I'd be mom's
mask.
Here
in the Pacific Northwest, I think of a baby deer sticking its head up out of the fern. Maker and model, Pepper Berry. Nature's Archer. My design is inspired by the archer deep in the forest. The huntress blends with the forest, respecting its ecosystems, taking only what she needs. The flowers, ferns, and vines on the blouse are inspired by materials and colors from Ragfinery. The black corset transformed from the back. Half circle skirt was a math problem using the eye. completely designed, cut, and sewn without a pattern. Using string, it pulls up for a fast getaway. Pants allow for a tight skirt.
Thank you.
expression.
Oh, thank you so much.
Next is number 9. Maker Patty Robinson, model Ellie Huntley, a spring garden wedding gown. Overseas. plant and animal-like all-age life. Raven Woman's wisdom is grounded by flowering trees that leaf out with repurposed ribbon through the silk shirt. Antlers adorned with feathers made from scarves, dresses, and skirts symbolize her spiritual authority over regrowth and renewal. In earth-friendly recycled fabric, Raven Woman ensures the balance of all and the fairness of the room give way to the colorful spring blooms and the joyous continuity of the given life of summer. Raven Woman. Next is number 14, because that comes after 13. Maker and model, Kara Ernie, Magnolia Wren. Kara used a variety of materials such as lace, satin, and chiffon to create this look. By combining her interest in sewing and her background in environmental art, Kara brought her idea of Mother Nature character to life. She let the material speak to her, slowly collecting fabrics over the course of the challenge to make this uniform. The green floral fabric was the first piece chosen for this look, setting the scene for the flowing and elegant design. Next we have number 15. Maker and model, Leah Laura, Royal Botanical. This is a dress with classic silhouette and attention to detail. A large bolt of blue fabric was purchased from Ragfinery to make the outer portion of the dress, and the lining was pieced together from other garments. Made from scrap, the sleeves are shaped into velvety flower petals. Organic texture that was very grass-like. Beads were meticulously removed one by one from a beaded top to create the jewelry that's worn around the neck. Royal Botanical. Next we have number 17. Maker and model, Kim Masser. The Faraway Tree. British children's books. The Faraway Tree is large and loving. There are many worlds and characters that live in the tree. Children that live near the woods discover the tree and go on fantastic adventures. Led up the tree by a fairy, Ragfinery. Makeup Thank you. Next we have number 18. Maker and model Kate Reed. Is more than weed. It is a little bit of sunshine. Each petal is a promise of hope for a wish to be granted. From a very large bowl of yellow fabric comes a bit more than 250 dandelion petals that make it
excited. With that, she took part of this new project.
woodland creatures. Maker and model Roslyn McKay, a touch of spring. Roslyn was excited to do this competition as it was her first big sewing project. She was especially inspired by the flora aspect of the competition. She took a plain off-white dress and altered it to better fit the theme. Over the course of working on this project, asymmetrical hem and embellishing it with sparkly and frilly trims. Envisioning dazzling plumage, red wings, and long graceful tail, we layered on flowing cape, pieced in shiny, jewel-drawn fabric remnants, and then fashioned a feathered headpiece. Our goal is to combine elegance and sophistication with the
you mean to bump you with my partner, my monobus? All right, you're good, you're good. See, what I told him to do was to get the little girl to put the owl mask on, and I could videotape that, and he just stole the photo off there.
Maker and model Jamie Holmes. This is Woodland Bride. The tool skirt is the first item I found in this project and was the inspiration for this piece. Gray fabric and remnants and green thread embellish the skirt with the spines and foliage. The top was hand embroidered and heather embroidery came from the end of a vintage pillowcase. Remnants and tool were used to make flowers for the bouquet. And now, number 26. Makers, Blanca Flor, Waldrop, and Anna Teachworth. Model, Anna Teachworth. Crocheted forest fairy. Inspired by gypsy sports, upcycled couture, dip-dyed wedding dresses, and traditional folk arts such as embroidery and